Welcome back to Five Live. A Five Live favorite here, Chef Aaren from Hotel Irwin. You guys are doing something a little different. It's now time for brunch, brunch season, you would think, because summer really starts in September in LA. I don't know if you've been outside lately. So you have a whole different menu here. We're going to start making some food, but first tell us what we're looking at that's on the table.
Okay, first we have a chilaquiles with house-made salsa. We have an avocado toast with smoked salmon.
I mean, you can't not do avocado toast.
True. Exactly. It's a California signature. For sure. Acai with fresh berries and house-made granola. Tots as an option for a side. And we will be making aji verde sauce for our lomo saltado burrito that I will be rolling up in just a few seconds.
So I see the ingredients for the burrito, and something interesting that is in here is French fries.
Yes. Yes. So in Peru, potatoes is a really big signature for them. This specific dish is filet mignon or sirloin. In this case, we're using filet mignon. Onions, tomatoes, French fries, and a lomo sauce that contains soy sauce, brown sugar, and red wine vinegar.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, let's get to making this actual sauce, because the other cool thing about this is I'm from LA, born and raised, and you're gonna teach us how to roll the perfect burrito. I still can't do it. You would think that it's something I've learned in the last 30 or so years, but you'll give us the exact clue, so make sure you guys pay attention there.
Sure. So first we're gonna make the salsa.
Okay. So you have a little tiny bit of water in there.
Yeah, so I already started with a little bit of water. Okay. Lots of cilantro. I'll make a little mess over here. Green onions. Okay. Some fresh fresh garlic.
And that's a huge Vitamix.
Yes. Some mayonnaise. Secret recipe. Yes.
Is the Vitamix truly the key to a good chef? Because I keep buying the knockoff because I don't want to just go for it. But everyone says just get the Vitamix.
Just get the Vitamix. Okay, right. Just get that Vitamix.
Okay. By the time you buy two knockoffs.
I know. I should have just gotten straight from the get-go.
Yes. One. Cotija.
Okay.
So lots of that. So
why that's gonna make it creamy. Why is mayo the secret ingredient?
My secret ingredient.
Yeah.
Some people don't put it. I do put it. I just feel like it makes it a little more creamier.
Okay.
So, and then aji amarillo, which is a Peruvian chili. It's pretty spicy.
Oh.
It's not gonna change the color too much. And I might have to put a little bit more water just to blend it up. And then some fresh lime juice.
Nice.
These limes aren't so juicy.
There you go. Use
those. But I'll try.
Yeah. I know.
Isn't it weird though? Like this small thing can struggle. You can struggle so much.
No, for sure.
You think
and
you could just
sometimes crush. I even like drop it in the blender. Nobody saw that, right?
Yeah, we've been to Hotel Irwin before, and you're really active in the kitchen.
Yes.
You're not just do this, do that. You're on the line. You're helping out, and it's really impressive.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I mean, our kitchen line is so. I'm gonna come over here and turn the switch on.
Yeah, we're watching you work right now.
It's gonna be loud.
Gonna be a little loud.
Oh, but not.
So we're gonna turn it up. It's a pretty nice blender. Mix that up. Turn it up. Turn it off.
That was unbelievably easy.
Okay, so my knockoff that would have taken four different times, a pickup, a little hit, a little shake. Should have just gone with the Vitamix, I guess.
So we did not. Yep, exactly.
Okay.
It's really fast.
So this is coming off.
So
it smells incredible.
Yeah. So if you can see.
I'll be the first taste test.
Sure.
I know, Sam. I'm going to be your spice-o-meter
here.
Yes,
please.
Because I know I don't want you to have too much spice, but it smells so good. The cilantro
smells
so,
fresh.
So good. Yeah, you won't be okay with this.
Is it a little too spicy for you?
Let mom have this.
Well, good thing I just was busy making this tortilla.
Wow.
Yay.
All right, so
thank
we have the tortilla warm. You say the key is warm it up for about 25 seconds.
Also, yes. Maybe
or
I'm
fresh
just buying
hot.
The wrong size.
I know, that's massive. A ginormous one.
They make it a lot easier, though.
So my grandma did teach me how to roll a fresh burrito, and I'm just waiting to see if I'm doing the same thing you do.
Okay.
So this burrito comes with two eggs.
Yes.
Okay. Cheese.
The filet mignon, the french fries.
Oh.
This looks amazing.
The tomatoes.
I want
to go there now. Ooh. Yes. So you want to try to keep it like towards the middle.
Okay.
That's the little key there. And you don't want to overstuff it too
go
much.
Go up, not out, when you're filling the burrito.
Yeah, you want because you'll even it out a little bit.
I feel like, though, that's a good, you know, you're hungry when you're making stuff.
So
overfilling. Spoon. That's where people make their mistakes.
Yes, here's a spoon.
Perfect. So we're going to, thank you.
How much of this? Do you go a little crazy? Do we stay light on this, baby? You make it look so pretty.
A little dabble.
Actually, this looks gorgeous.
I would usually have it in like a little squeeze bottle. I won't put too much.
Okay.
For the.
Perfect.
Non-spicy eater. Okay. So first,
yeah,
we're gonna fold it this way.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're gonna come over here and these fingers, we're gonna squish it in. These, we're gonna squish, squish, squish.
Beautiful.
Wow.
So now I'm gonna try to, I can see my little egg yolk over there. I'm gonna try to get it.
Oh, come on.
Ready? Ooh, that side was better.
Beautiful.
Yeah. So a pinch, and then you put the sides, and then you roll it over, right?
Yeah. The tuck.
And we usually have a plancha, so we'll like close it a little bit on this end, so it doesn't like unravel a little bit while you're eating it. You could just scarf it down.
Is it a sin to take a bite?
No, it's not.
The yolk looks so good.
Oh, it's art. It's beautiful.
Are you gonna take a bite? I would say take a bite of that one.
All right. Somebody talk though.
So I work to order people around. Well, I will. As you eat it, you can go get your own burrito any weekend at Hotel Irwin. 11:30 to 2:30 is when they're going to have live music from artists all around Southern California. And then 3:00, some things get weird. DJ comes out. It's hotter. Drinks have been flowing a little bit because you guys do have some good cocktails out there.
Yeah.
The setup with the new bar and everything that's done, one of my favorite places in LA.
This is so fresh. And refresh. I don't know how to make a burrito refreshing.
This is
a breakfast burrito.
It's the salsa.
It's the salsa, and it's not. I haven't gotten a big bite yet, but it's not crazy spicy. So don't be intimidated.
Like, maybe by itself.
I feel like by the end of this show, hopefully it never ends.
Yeah. End of the segment.
Aaren, thank you so much for coming in, Hotel Irwin in Venice, right there on the water. It's a great way to spend your Saturday or Sunday. Thanks for feeding us, as usual.
Of course, thank you for having me. It was a pleasure.
We'll see you guys.
Bye.
Chilaquiles.
Chilaquiles.
All looking fine.